Today, we're going to be looking at Adobe Illustrator CC 2018 updates for you to use in your graphic design workflow. What is up, people? It's Thomas of Toro Graphics, back again with another graphic design tip video. Today, we're looking at Adobe Illustrator CC 2018 updates for you to use on your graphic design projects and your workflow. So this video today is totally geared towards Illustrator CC, and if you don't actually have CC, then I don't think you're going to be privy to the Adobe Illustrator 2018 updates in today's video. But if you do have CC and you haven't updated Illustrator yet, go ahead and open up the Creative Cloud app, and you're going to be informed of what updates you actually have available to you. So as you can see here, I can update Photoshop and many other programs, but you need to make sure you close the program so you can actually activate the update. I have a few cool functions to show you today, but there was a slightly earlier update with the Puppet Transform tool in Illustrator, and I've already showed that on this channel, so I'm not going to include it today as well. The first new cool function in Adobe Illustrator 2018 relates to the anchor points and the pen tool handles. Thanks to the new update, we can now adjust the size of the anchor points and the handles, which is really helpful. To do this, go ahead and open up Illustrator Preferences and locate the selection and anchor display. In the new Adobe Illustrator updates for CC, we have a slider that will change the size of the anchor points and the handles. So as you can see now in the square here, the anchor points are enlarged as well as the pen tool handles. For me, I've personally set them in between the maximum and the standard size for the majority of my work. So that is the first update for Adobe Illustrator 2018. Let's check out the next one. Adobe has given us a very handy properties window where we can now have a quick access to specific tools and functions. This will relate to the current object or the design that you're actually working on. So open up the properties window in Adobe Illustrator CC 2018, and as I select this logo here, you can see the window snaps to specific information on this design. It gives me vector coordinates for the location of the graphics, and I can quickly add a stroke to my design as well as increase the stroke weight. I can mirror reflect the design, I can add effects, and there are really so much more essential functions here in this window, and it allows you to access them all in quick time. What do you think of this specific update? Let me know in the comment section below if you think it's handy, and if you actually already use it in Adobe Illustrator 2018. So the last function in today's video that I'm going to show you guys is a new feature that Adobe has added relating to importing PDF files. Now when we go ahead and import a PDF of multiple pages, we can select specific pages to upload. We can of course flick through the preview viewer and then type in exactly what pages to open. So I'm going to choose pages 1 through 4 for my magazine layout. Then once we've imported it into Illustrator, we have multiple options at the top here. We can image trace, we can embed, which is super helpful, and also we can edit the original artwork. So there was a quick video showing you guys the new features of Adobe Illustrator 2018. You can expect more updates through this year, but as of March 2018, these are the newest additions. If you found today's video useful, go ahead and drop a like and a comment letting me know. And also, if you haven't done already, subscribe to Tutorial Graphics for weekly graphic design content. Until next time, design your future today. Peace.